Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, The House of Secure Network. Okay, today we are discussing data protection, where we'll find out what is data protection, or in other words, cloud data protection. Why do you need cloud data protection? How can you protect your data? And finally, the benefits of cloud data protection. So let's get started right after this short intro. Data protection is a process of safeguarding important information from being corrupted, compromised, or losing them all. In other words, it's a practice to secure the data in all forms, be it data at rest, where data is untouched. Oh, by the way, do subscribe to my channel or hit that bell icon to get notified every time I drop a new video. Okay, moving on with data in transit, where data is in motion, and the last one, where data is in use. Here's a quick example. A laptop is the best device to explain data is at rest and untouched. Now let's say you're uploading some data on the web or to any application, which means your data is in motion or in transit. At last, consider a file that you're editing at the moment, which means the data is still in use. Okay, let's move on. We need cloud protection to save ourselves from cybercrimes, of course, but to know which data is saved where and where it's located, which of these applications are being used and by whom. We don't know what's really happening within those applications that are being used, which data needs protection and at what level of security is required. At last, we need a 360-degree visibility as to what is really happening on the cloud, right? Imagine an organization who has multiple cloud environments where they have stored various elements like storage, applications, or other infrastructure services, but nobody knows where the data is and where it's going once it is released by the user. Scary, isn't it? So how exactly can you protect this data? The primary step towards data protection is to know where the data is located and where it's going. In other words, the source and the destination is very important. Let's say when you're trying to upload some data on the cloud, you obviously know the source, which is your office, but you also should know what is the destination. Right after you know the source and destination, encrypting your data which is in the cloud is the very second step you should follow. Okay, once you find out where the data is, it is imperative that all those channels from where the data flows in and out should be encrypted using secure algorithms. And when you're done encrypting your data, you gotta back it up. Back up all those data which is on the cloud. Imagine your huge chunks of data is being encrypted now, but it is not backed up. And you are suddenly stuck with a cyber attack. What will happen? You will lose all your data even though it's encrypted. What comes next is ensuring a strong protection is enabled at all levels of the endpoint, the network level, and the email channel too. Imagine a user is editing an organization's legal document while his laptop is not protected. He can do anything with that, right? Send it to his personal email ID or leak it with a third party, which of course will lead to a huge loss for his organization. In another scenario, where a user is trying to upload certain confidential data to a Dropbox for his personal use. Again, a security breach, right? That may cost his company a fortune in no time. Here's why the network level should be protected. And finally, the easiest way to leak any stuff is via email. The email channel is the most vulnerable out of all, from where the data can be exfiltrated. All these channels need to be well protected. In the end, do not forget to educate the workforce. If everyone learns to be responsible enough to know what is wrong and what is right, I guarantee there cannot be any breach within an organization for sure. So how do we educate them? Either educate them by emails or by conducting short seminars to explain them the right ways of using the confidential data. Every organization will benefit by keeping their application data secure and sound, get the sites of complete visibility of the cloud environment, quickly mitigate any risks if they are found, govern standard policies across the organization to define the best practices, and finally, they can prevent their data without losing anything. In my next segment, I'll talk about few of the best solutions in the market for data loss prevention. Which solutions can provide a complete visibility of your cloud applications, and what are the best encryption tools that provide amazing level of security. So keep watching House of Secure Network, and goodbye until next time.